Hi guys, Miss Katlyn here again. I'm gonna read you guys another story, but first let's go do this worship song. Before we get started on our story today, I want to ask you guys two questions. What is the most expensive thing that you could think of?
A boat.
What about you guys? Now, if somebody gave you a lot of money, what would you spend it on?
The mall.
Oh, I know.
A bike.
A dirt bike.
Gun.
What about you guys? Those things do sound great, that we're going to be reading in the book of John. So if you have your Bible, go ahead and gather that up so you can follow along with us. But in our story, a woman named Martha, she brings perfume and she pours it on Jesus' feet and she wipes it with her hair. Now Judas is there and he thinks she's just wasting money, wasting this perfume, and he starts to criticize her. Then Jesus speaks up and says, I am worth more than money. I am worth more than that money that she spent on that person. So we're going to open our Bible to the book of John, chapter 12. We're going to be reading John 12, 1 through 8. It was 6 days before the Passover feast. Jesus came to Bethany where Lazarus lived. Lazarus was the one Jesus had raised from the dead. A dinner was given at Bethany to honor Jesus. Martha served the food. Lazarus was among the people at the table with Jesus. Then Mary took out a pint of pure nard. It was an expensive perfume. She poured it on Jesus' feet and then wiped them with her hair. The house was filled with a sweet smell of perfume. But Judas didn't like what Mary did. He was one of Jesus' disciples. Later, he was going to hand Jesus over to his enemy. Judas said, "Why wasn't this perfume sold? Why wasn't the money given to the poor people? It was worth a year's pay." He didn't say this because he cared about the poor. He said it because he was a thief. Judas was in charge of the money bag, and he used to help himself to what was in it. "Leave her alone," Jesus replied. "The perfume was meant for the day I am buried. You will always have the poor among you, but you won't always have me." I want you to take away from this story isn't that we should go pouring, you know, perfume on our pastor's feet. Of course not. What it means, though, is that nothing is worth more than Jesus. The perfume that she had, yeah, it was worth a lot of money, and it was expensive, but it wasn't worth more than Jesus. She wasn't wasting it by using it on Jesus. Before we end, let's pray real fast. Go ahead and fold your hands, bow your head, and close your eyes. Dear Lord, thank you for this day. Thank you for dying on the cross and being there for us. Please help us to remember that you are worth more than anything in this world, Lord. And please help us to put you before everything. Well, thank you for it. In Jesus' name, amen. So I wanted to give you guys a little activity to do. First, you need to gather your supplies. You need a piece of paper, a paintbrush, paint or a pencil if you don't have paint, and some lotion or some oil. First, what you're gonna do if you have the paint is paint the bottom of your foot. Then you're gonna use that foot to make an imprint on the paper. Lift it up and let dry. If you don't have paint, you could use a pencil to trace your foot. And then what you're going to do, you're going to get your lotion or your oil, your paintbrush, and you're going to paint on the lotion onto your foot. And then you're going to smell it, and your house should be filled with the fragrance from the lotion, just like it was in our story today. Hope you guys enjoyed it, and I'll see you next time. Bye.